Arrivederci, Roma. Goodbye, goodbye to Rome, city of a million moonlit places, city of a million warm embraces, where I found the one of all the faces, far from home.
Hell, bro.
You want to start it off?
I guess so. What were your thoughts when you graduated?
Honestly, I didn't really think much of it when I graduated. I was mainly focused on about like what I was going to pursue, right? And that was kind of different, yeah, what I was going to pursue, because it was such a, I was so delayed to it. Like, I wasn't even thinking about like my whole high school career. I wasn't even thinking about none of that. I was just mainly focused on football and whatnot. And I didn't really think like, all right, career, bro. I didn't think nothing of it, and I didn't plan. I had no plan or nothing. The day whenever you had told me to like go spend the, what's it called, the night over at your house, bro.
Did
the whole video things, bro.
Are you serious?
That's when I was like, bro, I dead ass can't stop thinking of this.
Like, I thought you had liked this shit before.
I did.
You never told me that. What the fuck?
Yeah, I did. But like it started turning into like an obsession, right? With like editing, that's why I spent so much time editing and all that.
I mean, I felt when I graduated, it didn't feel real at a point, because usually I was expecting something bigger though. Like when everyone said, when you graduate high school, it's the best thing in your life, yada yada yada. And then when we graduated, bro, I was kind of like,
yeah, like what now?
No, I'm saying like, it was weird. It was like usually going to school next year, you got a whole school year.
Yeah, you got a whole school year, and then like the whole school plans everything, what days you go, what days you don't go. And then after high school, you have to figure out everything. So like, it's just something, I have to find like a new obsession, right? And which I found it, right? It's like just creating art, really. That's like, cause it makes my mind flow. It's just, it helps me like think, bro. Like the images inside your brain, bro, you can just like put them out and people.
It's the best form of art, bro, I swear.
For people to like, you know, see and like, you know, if you're really like a good artist, bro, a good artist, bro, makes other people feel the same way that you felt. That's what makes you a good artist.
Because artists understand that it's not just about like, your stuff looks good. It's about how it makes you feel. And if an artist can pick out an emotion, like that exact emotion from a certain image to make you feel a certain way, they're the ones that understand the mind the most.
Yeah, honestly.
To be a true artist, you gotta understand what the mind does.
Yes.
You gotta understand psychology, bro.
Honestly, bro.
You gotta break all that shit down.
Dude, I started like realizing that the more I was watching like videos about film, right, and about like acting and then, like, you know, like these certain shots that like, you know, these people, when people watch something, bro, there's certain emotions that goes on in their brain, but they don't know it because it's happening so quick that your brain can't really process it until you like sit down and actually focus on it, right?
Yes. The angle of a shot can change the emotion that you feel in your brain.
It can make you feel uneasy, or it can make you satisfied, like with
intense.
The proportions and everything.
We're good. Thank you. Appreciate it.
What is something that you've learned, like throughout this like couple of since you graduated? Because when was the last time we've done our last video, the life flows?
The first one was what, 7 months ago? Something like that?
Yeah, it was after...
Prom.
Ooh, that was a minute ago.
Yeah, that was a minute ago. So it was after prom.
What have you learned so far?
Yeah. Like, especially you, bro. I feel like you developed in your creativity, honestly, and your patience, too.
When this year started, it's so funny you say that. My whole life, I've had a big trouble with, like, being patient, right, for anything. So... When the year started, 2000, like New Year's just popped off, just in 2023. I sat by myself and I prayed. I said, God, teach me patience. Like, I want to learn patience, because that's the only thing that's going to set me back. If I keep rushing everything, I keep rushing videos, I keep rushing money, my life's going to be destroyed. Teach me how to be patient. And in all 2023, I've gotten so much stuff I've always wanted, but I had to wait for everything. Everything wasn't instantaneous. Either I did everything I could do, and I just sat there and just let shit happen. I just sat there and just let it happen. I absorbed information. That's the reason why I got so patient, because of God, bro. I swear, like, even with my laptop, I sold my laptop originally bought. I remember that whole day. And the guy I originally was going to buy it from canceled on me. So I'm like, fuck, I got
to go to college in 3 days. I don't have a laptop. I need a computer, bro. I was stressing. I did everything. I contacted so many people on Facebook from, like, all the way to Oklahoma. I was going to make the drive.
Really?
And then, like, I just said, bro, I need to be patient. I just sat back, I threw it up, and I just started chilling, bro. I swear. Awesome. Thank you. I'm okay. I appreciate it.
I had to take multiple chances in my life, bro. Like, a lot of them, and a lot of it was confidence, too. I feel like isolation really helped me with my confidence, too. You know, reassuring in myself and who I am as a person, right, and what I'm capable of.
Yeah. I mean, bro, when it comes down to it, I mean, humans are fearful for things, and a lot of people are held down by the objects around them. Like, we're going to see with our friends and our peers that we graduated with, they're going to be stuck in a certain lifestyle because they got comfortable with it.
Yeah.
They got comfortable in a job, and they can't leave that job because they'll lose the things they're fearful of.
Yeah.
Like, if they stop working that job, they might lose their house, they might lose their car, they might lose all these things, their Netflix account, their comfort.
Yeah.
And they got to get stuck in that comfort, and they never excel, because they can't now. They're blinded by materialistic things. So I feel like with your situation, even mine, not having a lot of stuff right now is the best thing ever.
You think so?
We're not held down by shit.
Yeah.
We can go anywhere, do anything. The only thing that's stopping us is money and fear of not being able to do it. That's it, bro. Because you don't have anything. You don't have a lot. You don't have anything. You can throw all your shit in a car.
Honestly.
You can put all the things in your ultimate. I do the same thing with my stuff.
Honestly.
We can throw that shit in like a van and we're good. Not being held down by a lot of shit is the best thing. You can go and do everything you want. You're not held down by a job. I have them on materialistic things. The only thing you're held down from is me. That's it. And like being able to say, fuck it. Because you have nothing to lose right now. Nothing at all. Like, nothing to lose, bro.
And I feel like this is the best time to go try different things, right? Because you could fail. At this age, you could fail multiple times and you could get right back up.
Yeah.
Because you got time.
Yeah.
A lot of people, they would like pressure me to like, what's it called? You're 18, or your years are going to go by quick, this and that. But like, they are going to go quick. But like, if you don't try different things, if you're like always afraid to like, you know, fail or something, you're never going to find your actual life.
Yeah.
You know?
What you love to do. Because like at that point, you're dying early, dude, I swear.
You're
going to a job you don't care about, you're sad about.
And then you're sticking to that one thing. And
you never branch off.
Yeah, you never branch off.
You're just a normal person. Uh-huh. You fade into society, bro, and that's what the government wants. Because that's how they make the money off of you, bro. I'm sorry, that just goes back down to it. They cycle you out and like, they drain you out to make you this fucking bot. That just flows to society.
But this, I feel like when I turn 18, I start having more responsibilities. You start seeing like the actual, what the world is. You start like, your eyes start like opening. You can have the parenting, right? But it's mainly like your mindset, right? The way you think is like, you can have bad parents and you like, you know, get out of that situation through your mindset, right?
But that's also what you see though.
Yeah, that's also what you see.
So if your parents are living that life, steady income, they don't really take a lot of risks, they kind of just get the check and go to sleep. That's what you're gonna come accustomed to. You don't really see like what's more in life.